Oh, hey, I didn't see you standing there. We're back in Minnesota. I'm Gary Johnson from the University of Minnesota Department of Forest Resources. And today we're going to be talking about another step in the best planting practices process. And this is conducting a percolation test. If you don't usually do this, you're putting yourself at risk because you can't just look at soil and tell whether or not it's well drained, poorly drained, somewhere in the middle at the real extremes if you don't run a percolation test. This is one of those things that we're going to talk about today that's absolutely free to do. So if you have, for instance, an auger, a fence post auger, or ice fishing auger, you can drill the holes with it with that. If you don't have one of those, you can just use a plain old fence post jobber. It does perfectly good job. The depth you need to go down to is 24 inches, which would be right about there. So that's the depth of the hole. And what we're looking for ideally is we have a landscape soil that will drain 24 or percolate, drain 24 inches of water in 24 hours. So that's our hope for this. So once you dig the hole 24 inches deep, then the first thing you do is you fill it with water. And what I found with, I didn't fill it up because we're just pushing through this. What I found is if you use a 3-inch diameter or a 4-inch diameter auger or a jobber, it takes about 5 gallons of water to fill it up once. So you let it completely drain. And what's actually happening here is it's draining vertically, it's percolating, but it's also saturating the soil. It's also moving or diffusing to the sides too. We want to know how fast it percolates. This gravitational flow. So once it completely drains, then you fill it up a second time. And that second time, this is the one that you actually time. Do not sit here in a chair for 24 hours watching this go down, or 12 hours or 30 hours. Just come back 24 hours from now. If it's completely drained, you have a decent soil and you're not going to have to worry about overwatering plants or flooding plants. Now, having said that, I've run percolation tests all over the state of Minnesota. I remember once we were running them in Brainerd, I couldn't even get the hole to fill up the first time. It's pretty much sugar sand, and it was just like flushing a toilet. So in that case, you don't have a poorly drained soil. You have a soil that has no capacity to hold the moisture. So when you get ready to plant in that site, you're going to have to amend it with something organic that's going to hold moisture a little bit better. And surface mulch is going to be critical. Flipping it over, I've also had other places where I filled it the first time. I've come back 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, that water level is still almost at the top. Now you have a tough decision to make. I hope you like willows or sycamores or cottonwoods, because those are about the only trees that are going to grow there, maybe a silver maple. Or you can bring in soil and create a planting berm, get it above that poorly drained soil. Or sometimes you can come through with an auger down through it, and maybe it's not percolating well because there's a clay layer or blue clay layer, and sometimes you can drill right through that, then everything is good. But until you do it, you don't know whether or not the plants that you love are going to survive well in this site. Thanks for joining us.